The inference can be drawn that the soldiers under the command of General Gotovina had been given free rein to loot and burn and even kill. With impunity in furtherance of the objective of forcibly removing the Serbian population from the Krajina.
The looting and burning is taking place. I describe my own observations in Petrinja. Going there, I think on the 6th of August, a few hours after it fell, again, the Croatian military fully in charge, going back there on the 9th with increasing signs of looting.
I saw military people looting houses. It could be civilians that are having military uniforms. On the other hand, the vehicles were much pointing on the fact that it must have been, and it was, in my mind, quite clear that it should be military persons.
There were Croatian soldiers that were openly looting houses along that road.
Now, this picture shows a man in olive green uniform loading what seems to be a television into the truck. Did you see scenes like this in Gračac on 8th August, sir?
Oh, yes, I did, yes.
Mr. Simic, we see a list. Of close to 100 items that were taken from Croatian army members. Why were they taken from these persons?
Can you explain to court, based on your observations, what this man is supposed to be doing here?
He's a member of that Delta unit to whose commander I have been spoke, and he's cutting short some wires for stealing that private vehicle.
So after leaving Vrbnik, we followed on that road, got to Kastanja. There was many more soldiers in Kastanja than there was in Vrbnik. I would say company size in total. Again, they were wearing their normal HV uniforms, and they were actively looting and sacking the town of Kastanja.
I had embassy officers down in Knin coming up to some Croatian soldiers. And saying, the house is on fire, are you going to do anything about it? And then realizing that these were the people setting the fires.
We had seen a large number of fires on the road between Knin and Drniš. There were also a number of reports at that time from some other UN observers in the field. And we also noted that virtually all of this burning was taking place in areas in which all combat activities had stopped. So there seemed to be no plausible connection, if anyone wished to make one, between any ongoing fighting and the burning.
The town was being destroyed. Some houses would not be destroyed, and they would either put a symbol on those houses identifying as a Croatian house, and the remainder of the houses would be destroyed.
coming on September 20th to Doni Lapaz, a town that was 98% Serb, I believe, the most Serb municipality in Croatia, in which, in my estimation, 70% of the buildings in Doni Lapaz, and these were apartment blocks and things of like, had been torched. None of them had been damaged in fighting. They had been systematically torched, and all the ones that hadn't been torched had been looted.
The assertions made that civilians bent on revenge were largely responsible is not unreasonable.
Dakle, nije bio plan da se pljačka i pali nakon Oluje. To nije imalo nikakvog rezona.
Nisam nikada čuo niti osjetio atmosferu u Ministarstvu unutarnjih poslova koja bi išla tim pravcem.
It is true that when the troops entered Knin, in their state of jubilation, they began to engage in looting. Not of any great scale.
U svakom zaseoku jedna do dvije, maksimalno tri kuće ako su zapaljene u tom razdoblju. Nije bilo većeg obima, ali i to je bilo za nas previše.
Ja sam, na primjer, u Kistanju bio negdje, prošao sam kroz Kistanje 10. do 12. kolovoza. Bili smo u centru, ja nisam stekao dojam da je nešto posebno, puno kuća zapaljeno, jedan dio da, ali ne nešto puno, nešto značajno.
A o to što se dešavalo, pošto je bilo ljetno vrijeme, kad bi se ispucalo iz svjetlećeg metka, moguće je da zapali cjenik ili travu, a to je bilo jako zapaljivo. Jer su uvijek neko je puca vamo, neko puca tamo i ti meci moru zapaliti travu, seosku staju i tako.
Razumije se da u procesu oslobađanja tih područja sa hrvatske strane isto tako se nije moglo zadržati samo vođenje rata u nekakvim rukavicama. Prema tome da su najprije jugokomunistička armija i Srbi učinili užasne zločine u okviru takve jedne agresije stvaranja Velike Srbije, a da kasnije se u oslobađanju tih područja isto nije moglo suzdržati da se ljudi koji su pretrpjeli žrtve, koji su se vraćali te područje, da ne prave neke osvetničke čine i gluposti kao što je uništavanje kuća i tako dalje.
Nažalost, eto, mi smo bili u to vrijeme malo euforični, što alkohol u zraku je bio dim, miris baruta. Pijane glave, prisjetlim se neko svoje krave, životinje, neko je vidio kroz Oluju kad smo išli, kad smo prolazili, neko vidio svoju kravu, neko vidio svoju baču, neko vidio svoj traktor. Pa čak i ovce, prepoznali su kokoš, jer smo mi uzgajali baš u našem selu posebne kokoši i istarske tuke. Oni nisu, oni su drugi vrst tuka imali. Pa imali smo to te male stvari, sitne, ali su ljudi prepoznali svoje stvari, nosili kući. što ja to nisam smatrao uopće nešto posebno u ono vrijeme kriminalom. Jer to je sve to je zapravo bilo naše. Oni su sve to nama uzeli. I tako to je bilo u tom kontekstu smo išli. Nismo išli ubijati, da smo htjeli ubijati, ubijali bi od početka, ubili bi ih sve odmah.
Moja reakcija je bila izuzetno negativna. Mene osobno stid takvog ponašanja bilo. Ali ne samo stid, nego smo i tražili da se ti počinitelji pronađu i kazne. Ja sam razgovarala o tome sa predsjednikom. Bio je prilično nervozan i ljut zbog toga. Čak mi je rekao u jednom trenutku da je riječ o sabotaži i o podmetanju.
Jest. Poznato mi je, ali ne iz vlastitog iskustva, nisam bio prisutan. Ali sam čuo sasvim sigurno da su neka tijela istražna, da li policija temeljna ili vojna policija, u Gračacu uhitili nekog piromana koji se vozio sa nekim mopedićom i s benzinom usput zapalio kuću. Ali onda je uhićen.
Znam da su gorile sve te kuće i to, ali to je neko sasvim treći, četvrti, jer to vojska nije radila. Moja vojska nije i naša vojska, jer to je bilo strogo zabranjeno. Oni su bili svi upoznati sa tima činjenicama.
So you're not in a position to tell the trial chamber? What the motivation of this soldier could be in jump-starting this car?
Ne, gospodine tužitelju, može biti više razloga, može biti da je dobio nalog da ga skloni. A kako najvratnije nema ključe, on pokušava upaliti na način na koji je moguće upaliti taj auto.